And then I say this happens. Okay, so we're going
to
play it.
I'm happy to be here.
Trigger warning.
Yeah. I don't mean to brag. I don't care, but I want you to know, double vaxxed, booster, flu shot, and I'm going to be honest, I have the shingle shot too. And I still get my period. What? Yes. Traveled, went to Mexico twice, did shows, meet and greets, never got COVID. Clearly, Jesus loves me the most. Seriously. So nice. So nice.
Boom. Somebody once told me the world.
Look into the Great Reset world.
Imagine that an adult male wants to have sex with a 12-year-old girl. Imagine that she's a willing participant. A very standard, very widely held view that there's something deeply wrong about this, and it's wrong independent of it being criminalized. It's not obvious to me that it is, in fact, wrong. I think this is a mistake, and I think that exploring why it's a mistake will tell us not only things about adult-child sex and statutory rape, but also about fundamental principles of morality.
How did you get them alone?
Grooming. I would check out their family situation. I would check out their clothing to see how well they were, you know, financially. I would check out their social interaction with other kids. You know, when we were on the ballparks, or on the gym floor, you know, I would make sure which ones I wanted to molest. I would give them special attention, congratulate them, talk to them when I know that I would never be allowed to talk to anybody else, you know, aside from everybody. I would give them the attention that an official is not supposed to give anybody. And it made them feel like, wow, he's paying me attention. You know, it is a direct form of grooming.
Were there certain characteristics that you looked for in children before molesting them?
In children, yes, but more I also looked at their families. If I thought the father was a threat, I would not approach the child. If I thought that the child had friends that he would tell, I would not approach him. If I thought the child had friends that were in the same capacity he was, I would approach him. For the simple fact that if I could molest him, I could lure him into believing, grooming him into believing that he would enjoy it. And therefore, I could manipulate him into having his other friends come and be molested by me as well.
So perhaps a child that doesn't really have a whole lot of friends, maybe not really a strong family, things like that.
Yes, no spiritual values, weak in education, you know, needs help in many ways, even from split parenting, you know, has a mother who may be having problems with the family, you know, well, here comes superhero in to help out, you know, wow, well, thank you very much, no problem, you ever need me to take him away for the night so you can have a night out, no problem. It worked.
I throw a Molotov cocktail at the precinct. You know how we think. Organize the hood under I Ching banners. Red, black, and green instead of gang bandanas. FBI spying on us through the radio antennas. And I'm hitting cameras in the street like watching society. With no respect for the people's right to privacy. I take a slug for the cause like Huey P. While all you fake niggas try to copy Master P. I wanna be free to live, able to have what I need to live. Bring the power.
There is no facilitation of food, water, fuel, logistics, or funding by any member of this police service or any other police service that I am aware of. Let me repeat. There is no supply of food, water, fuel, logistics, or anything else that relates to enabling this demonstration by any member of the Audubon Police Service or any other police service that I am aware of. Should that information come to me, you can be clear, as chief of police in this service, I will conduct a full investigation. I will use the full extent of the Police Service Act and, if relevant, the criminal code to pursue charges against such a member who would do that.
We're back in the car. Back up. Let's go. Oh, we got a tape tonight. Hold the line, buddy. Hold the fucking line, buddy. Hold the fucking line.
You're a fucking bitch without that. You're a fucking bitch.
You need more. Yeah, go. We are the people.
You fucking midget.
We speak. Freedom! Look, they're scared. They're backing up.
That's right.
Yeah!
That's right.
Freedom!
We the people!
Not enough, yeah, right. Trudeau does. That's why you guys
finish one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style. I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox with
him, stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around, and I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down. Hey.
All right, so you guys aren't going to believe the latest out of Ottawa. Police say if you bring gas or food or supplies to any of the protesters, that's a crime now. They tried to mock it up as if it's aiding and abetting. The protest is lawful. The protesters are peaceful. The police chief literally just said that the other day. On the biggest day of the protest, there's zero arrests, zero cases of violence. But here's the funny part. They want to go after people bringing fuel and supplies to these truckers fighting for our freedom. Oh, well, why didn't you say so? Now everyone who shows up to this protest will be carrying a jerry can. You don't even need to have gas in it. You just take the jerry can. And guess what? If you do bring gas and you get caught for the illegal activity of giving gasoline to someone that you purchased, therefore it's your property that you're giving to someone, that's completely legal. You have a piece of history, a piece of paper from the revolution that you got ticketed because you were handing out gas to freedom fighters. And that ticket will be thrown out in court.
D is for drag. You can strut and dance in clothes that you love. Dresses, heels, or heels. That's you. M is for number nine. Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven? Or just being a girl. That's you. You'll find your fortune falling. P is for pen. You connect with a vibe no matter what you do. It's about umbrella.
So I recently told my parents that I may be a little bit romantically interested in women. And that was a big shock for them considering the past 10 years of coming out as gay, then queer, then non-binary, then trans. And I think it was just a bit of a shock. So I tell my dad and he goes, well, I would love to see you get a woman pregnant. And I said, oh, no, she would be getting me pregnant. And then he said, what, do you have a vagina now? And I said, never. Everything I say about gender is influenced by my whiteness, which is obvious, but there's an interesting second part to this. The rejections of gender and gender roles that I create and embody will still come from my whiteness, those acceptable to my constructions of self as a white person. I will likely uphold and encourage white beauty standards and see and more immediately accept other white rejections of gender. Essentially, even the most critical analysis of gender I have will still be white, and white gender rejection can and does uphold whiteness and white supremacy.
I think I'm losing my mind.
We stay focused. We continue to do the job and the mission that we signed up for. Right? We all signed up for it. We all raised our hand.
To defend the Constitution, not the
It's not hard to say it. It may be hard for you to say it, but I've been doing this for 31 years. It's not hard for me to say it. Every day I wake up and I'm committed to this organization and I'm committed to each one of y'all.
But then you keep releasing criminal aliens in the country.
You're getting bogged down in the policies and the politics.
You can't say illegal alien.
What's that?
That's why Chief Scott left.
You just said it.
You can't.
Is anything going to happen to you? You no, just said it. Yeah,
the whole generation. Whole generation.
Why are you guys getting caught up in semantics? Right? There's a mission out there to be. There's a mission out there to be here with you. We just sit here and argue about it till we're blue in the face. Right? I've been doing this job as long as y'all.
That's the problem.
What's that?
That's the problem, Chief. For evil to triumph, for good men to do nothing.
I can't hear you.
For evil to triumph is for good men to do nothing. That's exactly what's happening here. Good men are doing nothing. You're allowing the illegal aliens to drop off communities.
You are doing something.
No, sir, we're not.
You are. No, sir. You're rescuing people every day. You're taking fentanyl off the streets every day. You're taking methamphetamine
yes, on the aliens off the streets every day. We have the highest fentanyl death in the history of our country. In 1 year, in this country.
You know, we've made more fentanyl seizures already this year than we made last year.
How many have we not catched because we're focusing on experiments? And that's the problem.
And we're working on it.
Well, where's the results? We don't have results.
My grandfather walked 10 miles to work every day. My father walked 5. I'm driving a Cadillac. My son is in a Mercedes. Said my grandson will be in a Ferrari. He said my great-grandson will be walking again. So I asked him, I said, well, why is that? And he said to me, tough times create strong men. Strong men create easy times. Easy times create weak men. Weak men create tough times. He said to me, many will not understand, but you have to raise warriors.